as it's done, just like every cowboy sings a sad, sad song. And every rose as it's done.
Hey everybody, this is James at StrumSchool.com. And today we're going to learn the 80s classic, Every Rose Has Its Thorn by Poison. So at the beginning of the song, we're going to transition back and forth between two chords, a G major and a C add 9. That's a very easy transition to do because all you have to, the only change that happens really, is from the G chord shape, I bring my index and middle fingers up one string each. So I wind up on the fourth and fifth strings for the C and 9. And we don't play the low E string. And I'm going to show you these chords a little bit closer later on. So that's our verse, is essentially back and forth between. That G chord and the C chord. Toward the end of the verse, we start to speed up the harmonic rhythm. So I wind up playing the G, C, G, C, D. Now I'm going to my regular C here, right before it goes into the chorus. So I play a D major, and then a C. And then we're ready to go into the chorus, which we go back to those very familiar chords again of G through C add 9, G, C. Now I have G, D, C, G, G. Ends with the C add 9. We kind of hold that. Okay? So now here's the bridge. Some different chords here. I go to E minor, then I go to D, C add 9 again, then G, and we're going to do a little walk down from G in our bass line where we're going to go. So I'm playing G, F sharp, E. But I'm going to play them with chords, G, and then that F sharp is essentially a D major chord. What I'm doing is I'm putting an F sharp in the bass. I'm taking the F sharp that usually is up here, and I'm putting it down here. So fingering wise, I'm playing my first finger, open, open, second fret with my second finger, third fret with my third finger. So it would be, and then I'm back to E minor again. And then after the E, I go to D, C. Okay, so here's the whole bridge. One, two, three, four. So here's some of these chords a little bit closer. Here's the G chord. I take these two fingers, move them up a string, and I get the C add 9. Here's the D major chord. Here's the regular C chord. E minor, and then the D with the F sharp in the bass. So if you have any questions about this song or anything about guitar playing in general, you can find me at strumschool.com. There's my link. We can take a lesson, we can chat, we can do all sorts of things related to guitar, have fun, keep strumming, and it's a beautiful thing.